Hello everybody and welcome back to our YouTube channel. We are as always your hosts ARNE and Carlos.
And Porridgegate is on. I know that everybody wants to know what's going on with Porridgegate. If you haven't been following our quarantine podcast that we posted this spring, you'll know that there was something going on with our porridge in the morning that we have. We're going to tell you all about Porridgegate and we're going to be doing two recipes for those porridges that we may or may not be eating right now. We will reveal everything tomorrow morning. Now, ARNE, the first porridge that we're going to be doing for tomorrow is a overnight oat. It's cold.
And that I can do first part of this porridge because I'm not a good cook, but this I can do.
Yeah, and then I'll do the second part tomorrow morning.
Which I don't do. I can't do second part.
So, ingredients. What do we need for the porridge that is overnight and cold?
We need water.
Okay.
And we need this, what's this in English?
Oats.
Oats.
Yes.
And we need banana, one banana.
And raspberries.
Raspberries.
We're also going to need some almonds because we're going to make almond milk. This is actually a vegan recipe. And tomorrow morning, we will be adding some delicious pecan nut butter that I'm going to make myself and some maple syrup.
You better, because I'm not making that
much. Well, okay. Anyway, shall we start the procedure of making this morning porridge or this overnight porridge?
Then you should explain what I'm doing because I'm so bad with this cooking English. It's like I know, but this is a banana.
Okay.
But what do I do with the banana if I do it English?
Okay, I'll explain it.
First.
So first you take a banana. Yeah, you obviously.
You open the banana.
You open the banana.
You slip it down to this thing.
And you give me the peel. We put this in our bokashi because we recycle.
And now you squeeze the banana. This is actually very quick and easy. I don't know about the part you doing, Carlos, because...
Well, we'll see tomorrow.
I think I have never seen you do it. Have you ever seen me do this?
I've seen you do this. I love seeing you mushing bananas.
you told me how to do it. So. Okay. I don't think you like to smush the bananas.
I don't know. I just think it's fun that people get to watch you cook for once. Don't you think that's a
fun you call
thing?
This cooking? Look.
Yeah.
Mushed banana.
Okay. So what is the next thing you do?
The next thing, you have to put this havregryn.
The oats.
And you use like the same amount of oats as water. So let's do 2.5 deciliter.
So 2.5 deciliters of oat. I don't know what that is in ounces, but you can look it up. Just write 2.5 deciliters into ounces on Google and it'll tell you. We are metric here in Norway and that's good enough for me.
Maybe you can order this on the internet.
What?
The metric ball.
Yeah,
with the deciliter.
Yeah. Actually, hang on, because 2.5 deciliters of oatmeal is actually 1 cup. Hey! 1 cup of oatmeal.
Oh, this one has both.
Yes, thank you for reminding me.
I didn't remember. Oh yeah, it says one cup.
Okay. So.
Up with the banana. Yep. And now we need cold water.
Mm-hmm.
The same amount. This is really hard cooking. And remember, take the oats before you take the water. Because if you take the water and then the oats will be stuck in the...
And that's the tip for...
Or you need two of these.
Yeah, and that's the tip from MasterChef, ARNE.
Because I know by doing it.
And you know the...
I learned the hard way because I took water and then I took oats and it was stuck in the cup.
And you know the expression about salt I gröten, right?
Mm-hmm.
The salt in the porridge, it means... If you don't have enough to put salt in your porridge, enough money, then you're really poor.
So just a little bit.
A little pinch of salt goes in the porridge.
You can put salt later.
Mm-hmm. Okay.
And then you just do this. Stir it around. You mix all this together. That should be good. And then you put...
Raspberries
on top. Have you checked so there's no worms in this one?
Worms?
No, muck.
Worms. No, there's no worms in the raspberries.
So you put this, just this on top?
Mm-hmm. Looking good.
These are really nice.
Yeah, they're fresh.
Big. So, this is all you need to do today. And then you put something on top and you put it in the fridge. And then this one stays until tomorrow.
Tomorrow morning, yeah.
Tomorrow morning, yeah. Then you have to work.
Yeah. So that's step one. There's also a second step that we're going to do tonight because it needs to be done as well. Because we're
there's no space.
Well, you jiggle around while I explain the second part of this, while Arne jiggles around to find some space there. So this is a vegan recipe. Tomorrow, we're going to take out our overnight oats. We are going to mix that with some almond milk. And yes, you can go and buy almond milk in the supermarket. However, I find that the supermarket almond milk has a lot, has stuff like preservatives and sugar and, you know, all those things. And you can do it so easily at home. So I'm going to show you how to make almond milk because it's super easy. So what you need is almonds and some water. So I open my almond package.
So I can leave now?
No. I love you here as decoration.
I can
right
do
now.
Some knitting or something?
No, just smile. Okay. You look good.
Stay on the corner. Mm-hmm.
So we'll do a cup of almonds. Put that in our little bowl. And then I'm just going to fill this up with water. There you go. You've got some almonds in water.
I love almonds.
I do too. And, oh, you're stealing the almonds again, Arne. And then I wake up in the morning, I want this porridge, and there's no almonds, so I can't make the milk. Don't eat my almonds. And again, we're going to just cover this with a little plate. And this is going to stay overnight, and the almonds are going to fill with water. And then tomorrow, we're going to make the milk. So that's pretty much step one. Now we're going to, you know, continue enjoying our evening. And tomorrow morning, very, very early, we are going to be back downstairs. We're going to make the cold porridge, the overnight oats. And I'm also going to make the second porridge that is served warm. And it's going to be a yummy experience, I hope. And we will reveal where we are at in Porridgegate.
Yeah.
So good night, everybody. And we'll see you again tomorrow.
See you tomorrow.
Morning. Hey, good morning, everybody.
Good morning.
I hope you slept well. Did you sleep well?
Yeah.
Yeah, I see you've got a little bit of a something going on there. Yeah. So tea time.
Yeah, and now.
What are you doing?
I'm lighting the candles.
And I see you've been knitting as well. Oh, what are you doing? What are you knitting?
It's a secret.
Oh, a morning secret
morning
that I didn't
secret.
Know of.
It's my morning knitting.
Ah,
and
I
it's
see.
A secret.
Okay. Well, I'm sure I'm going to find out sooner or later. Yeah. So you're making it cozy, huh? Lighting up the candles, getting, you know, the mood for the porridge that we're looking forward to eating.
Which you are looking forward to eating, maybe. Okay. We'll see if I can have it.
Okay, so let's do part two. Our oats have been overnighting in the fridge. So Arne kind of did his job on that one. And now we're going to combine our ingredients together. In order to make, you know, finish this porridge up the way we want it to be.
Combine our talents.
Combine our talents. Yes, let's go. Let's go. Okay, so as you remember from yesterday evening, I have my almonds. They have been soaking overnight. And now I'm going to make the almond milk. And making your own almond milk is probably the easiest thing you can do in the whole world. All you need is a blender, and I've got this. This is a smoothie maker, but I like it. It's small and very compact. It's easy to take in and out of the kitchen. So what I do is I just put almonds in this smoothie maker, like this. And remember, I had about a cup of almonds, and I usually do 50-50, so I put half of my almonds in, and I blend this in first, and then I'll do the rest. But we're just gonna do half right now. And then I come here to the water, and I don't really have a recipe for how much water, but let's say I did a cup of almonds and let's see. I can do a cup and a half of water, about that much. And then take this. What are you doing, Arne? You're supposed to be helping me.
I'm waiting for.
Oh, okay. You get something. A job in a minute. You're gonna get a job in a minute. So put that in like so, and just blend the stuff. Blend it up. And here you go, Arne.
Yeah, now, give me a job.
Okay, so now you have to filter this for us. So literally just blending the water with the almonds that were soaked overnight. And look at the color. It's lovely white like milk.
I can do that.
And now what are we going to do, Arne?
You filter it.
Yeah.
And you remember when I was cleaning the kitchen and you had just made your almond milk?
Yeah, that was funny.
It wasn't funny at the time, I think.
No, I got pretty upset.
Yeah, you were.
Yeah, Arne was. I was making this porridge, and then Arne was cleaning the kitchen, and then if you lift up everything and put it on the counter, people will probably understand why you threw it all away. It was,
I think I said, do you need this? And
No.
I think you said, no, you don't need it.
So,
but you thought I was talking about
let
this.
It go. So, yeah, so let it go. It was like this on the counter. Okay, maybe you said that, do you need this? And I said, no, I'm done. So he took that, he threw that in the bokashi, and then he took all my almond milk, and down the sink it went. Imagine those almonds that I had soaked overnight with my own bare hands. And all the work
so
blending
angry.
Them, and then yeah, I was pretty angry. I was upset. Yes.
And that was when I liked the porridge.
No, I think that's when you started sabotaging my porridge.
Maybe that's why.
Yes, he was sabotaging my porridge unconsciously.
Never.
Okay. Anyway, could you pass me a spoon? So anyway, porridge is now, almond milk is now filtered, and I usually just squeeze the rest of the milk like this, and if you would taste this, you would taste the almond now. So it's kind of like an almond flavored water, and then I would do a second batch, and this you can keep in the refrigerator for I would say 2-3 days, and it will stay for a couple of days.
But this is for me.
Yeah, you can throw that away now, just don't touch the milk. Okay, so
to the bokashi.
Okay, so Arne, the lovely overnight oats. Mm-hmm. This is always exciting. The overnight oats in the banana, and if I start blending these raspberries in, you see that something has happened here overnight, and they are soft. The oats are soft and ready to eat. So, the next thing I do is I need that little measurement cup. It's on the sink. There you go. Yes, thank you. Oh. Thank you. So, the measurement cup, and I need about two deciliters of...
Which is one cup.
So, yeah, 2.5 deciliters. So, again, one cup.
One cup. 2.5.
And, it's just about a cup. Perfect. So I take my almond milk and I pour it into the bowl and just stir that in. Yummy.
Oh, I poured that out.
That's okay.
Okay.
Arne, look, yummy, delicious, cold porridge. You know you like it.
It reminds me of quarantine.
Yeah. Okay, so here it is. It's all nice and blended, looking delicious. so I suppose we need a bowl to a porridge bowl to put it in. Oh, just one's enough. And then we'll put the other porridge in the other, and then we'll
So then I have the warm one.
Yeah, we'll see. We'll see. We'll see. Anyway, so just plate that. Put the delicious porridge in. It's nice and cold and vegan. Very, very lovely. There, that's a nice portion. You know, breakfast is the most important meal of the day. I love a good breakfast. I love, love, love a good breakfast. I especially love hotel breakfasts, and we haven't had many of those in the last 6 months, have we?
No.
No hotel breakfasts.
No.
That's very sad. Okay, anyway, so the porridge is done, and now we need the final steps, because this needs some topping as well. And Arne, could you do me a final favor? Could you please fetch the almond or the pecan nut butter? Yeah, that's the one.
What?
With the mixer. Yes.
I'm so good.
Yeah, you're so such a good cook. Just bring it all in. We're going to show everybody how I made this. I wanted to make this in advance because it takes quite a lot of time and it is a little bit noisy. So what I've done, so Arne, shh, quiet.
Just give me a break. I just have to take this out from...
No, you don't. We're just going to shit. Okay. Good morning.
Good morning. Talk.
Porridgegate is definitely on. We are in Porridgegate right now. So, I take a pack of pecan nuts, open it, and then I poured it, if you would care to show our audience on. I poured it in there, the nuts, and then I took my blender, and I blended and blended and blended for quite some time. You want to blend those nuts until you get all the fat out of them, and so that it becomes kind of like some butter. It's
What are you talking about?
Like, I'm talking about porridge here.
You want to blend those nuts?
Yes.
Okay.
Yeah. So
isn't it a little bit too early for
okay.
that?
Okay. Okay. No more silliness at this hour, please. So you want to blend those pecan nuts quite a lot so that the fat starts coming out and it becomes this more of a buttery consistency. Thank you for your help.
You're welcome.
Yeah.
There's more here.
And as you can see, I think I need a second spoon. A big one. It is very early in the morning, so please forgive us. So, if you see the consistency, you can see it's very thick and kind of spreadable, like peanut butter, but pecan butter.
Why don't you use peanut butter?
Because pecan butter is nicer.
But you can use peanut butter.
Yeah, I can. So the topping of this porridge is very easy. I just grab a spoon of my homemade pecan butter, which I'm sure you can get in a store as well. And I just plunk that in, like this. Plunk. There we go, the lovely pecan butter. And then we want to sweeten it with something. And I'm not a big sugar person.
Actually, it looks good now.
It does.
This time it looks better.
It looks lovely. I'm not a very big person for sugar. I don't like that many sweet things. So I'm not going to exaggerate it. I'm just going to take a little bit of this maple syrup. It's real maple syrup from Canada. Just a little bit, like a spoon. That's pretty much it. And then I'm just going to drizzle this on top. And this is my natural sweetener. So here you go. Do you want to take that to the table?
I ate your almonds.
Okay. So there you have it. A nice, hearty portion, which is 100% vegan. There's nothing from animals in it. And where I pretty much made everything myself. I made the almond milk myself. I made the pecan butter myself. Arne mushed the banana with his own hands. So it's all 100% made here. With a fork, yeah, sorry. Yeah, you mushed it with a fork, obviously. Okay, that was porridge number one, Arne. Shall we move over to the warm
then
part
I
of the kitchen?
Make a few stitches while you're...
Oh, no, you're going to be working now. Mm-hmm. Okay, shall we start the second porridge?
Now you look really confused.
Well, it's very early in the morning. Okay, so the second porridge that we're going to do, that is one that we have a lot, is a steel-cut oat porridge, warm. What are you doing?
Is it too early?
No, it's okay. Anyway, we're doing a steel-cut oatmeal porridge, hot. And with that, we're going to do some delicious pears in salty caramel. That's so good.
Huh? Now I can fix the pears.
Okay, so while Arne starts... So the first thing we need to do is we've got these lovely pears. We've got two of them. So this is two portions of porridge in the morning. We've got two pears, and they need to be peeled, and they need to be sliced in small pieces. So Arne,
I can do that, but I'm going to sit over there.
Okay, do it wherever you like.
And I need a knife.
No, I put the knife here for you.
I use a small one.
But that's a bread knife.
I don't think the pear know the difference.
No, the pear doesn't know the difference between a bread knife and the rubber.
The pear is like screaming. It's like, no, no, don't kill me with the bread knife. I try to be funny, but it doesn't work.
Okay, anyway, while Arne is doing the pears, I'm going to do the oatmeal. This is one... You have to cook it according to the package. And this package says that you do one part steel cut and 3 to 4 parts water. So I'll do, let's see what I'm going to do. For two people, I am going to do approximately 2 deciliters of steel cut. Yep. Which is about 3/4 of a cup. So 2, and then I'll do 6 parts of water. 1, 2, 3.
I know why I have to do this, Carlos.
Because
you don't like to do this, because they are kind of disgusting to touch when you remove the...
Yeah, they're very gooey. Anyway, I bring that to a boil, and we need a little pinch of salt, very important with your porridge. I love pink Himalaya salt. So I'm going to put that in, just a tiny little pinch. There we go. And we're going to let that boil for 20 minutes. Now, somebody, we had these, in our publishing house, which is a pretty big one, in a few years ago, I think it was in 2016, there was a book on porridge, and we did an event with the authors of the book. It's a really beautiful book. It looks like this. And we got a lot of the ideas and inspirations from this beautiful book, which unfortunately is only available in Norwegian. Anyway, there's some interesting information about porridge in here. And one thing we learned was that if you actually take your steel cuts and you put them in a bowl and you soak it overnight, it releases more of those nutrients and vitamins and makes it even better. Yesterday we had a lot on our mind with the cold porridge, and we forgot to soak the steel cut oats. But I mean, on the other hand, if you don't soak it, you can cook it immediately because it's okay. But apparently, if you soak it overnight, you make it even more nutritious and more delicious, because you get all those substances out of the steel cut. So while Arne peels away, this is gonna boil, and we are going to make the pears in salty caramel, which is gonna be so good. How are you going with the pears? How is the cutting station doing?
It's working.
Yeah, you got the worst peeler out of the bunch.
But they are, it's so...
Are you sure you don't want the other peeler? No, oh, it's gone.
Oh, I don't care. As long as I get it off, I don't care which one I use. Oh. Mind your own business, sorry. Carlos.
Yes. Yeah, this is a lesson. I should mind my own business.
Don't have to think about how I peel, as long as I get rid of the skin.
I let things overboil every single day. I'm so distracted nowadays with all, you know, the stuff going on in the world. COVID.
Yeah. It's like you think about that all the time.
Yeah, I do. No. Well, I do. I mean, and if you don't think about it, the media will remind you there's a pandemic out there. And that we're not going to get hotel breakfasts for a very long time.
Long time.
Okay. There we go.
Oh, I swallowed it. Almond. It's not COVID.
What are you doing?
I was eating your almonds.
You see? You're not supposed to, and now you get punished for that. And don't cough on the pears.
This is probably not healthy, what I'm doing right now.
Did you cough on the pears?
No, I don't think so. I don't remember.
Okay, shall we do...
Eric has it on film.
Shall we do... Okay, we're doing new pears.
No, but we're like in the same house.
It's still disgusting if you coughed. Were you doing that when you coughed?
That's what I learned.
Oh, okay. And you did that when you were with the pears?
Mm-hmm.
Okay.
I did. But I was stealing almonds, and suddenly they got stuck in my throat.
We might have to edit out a few of these coughings because it's disgusting. Ja, men kom igen då. Det går väl an. Alltså, hur lång tid ska det ta att köra upp topärer? Ja.
Det är så äckligt.
Yeah, but you have to cut them. This is just incredible. I could have done this in
sleazy and disgusting.
Can I borrow your knitting?
No.
I mean, I might even finish that sweater before you finish cutting those prayers.
I'm taking this seriously.
I mean, this is gonna be done by the time I get those prayers back. I know you take it very seriously, and I know that you're gonna cut those prayers exactly the same size. But
no,
it's...
I'm not. I'm doing it like. Oh, look. Can we eat those seeds?
Yeah, but why don't you use this?
You don't use that on a pear. That's for apples. And this is for pears, not bread.
Okay. Okay.
You think I'm slow?
Yes, I do. I think you're the slowest.
You think if we stop knitting and do we could like open a kitchen or something, like a restaurant?
Okay, well, Arne is cutting the pears because, I mean, we are really...
The guests are getting cranky right now because the cook is so slow. Mm. But I think this is... I'm getting there.
Okay. So, Eric, in the meantime, because you want your porridge as well, you must be starving, and this the rate we're going here, it's going to be a while before you get your food. Anyway, we've got coconut oil, and this one is...
You want me to peel the coconut?
No, you're not going to peel any coconuts here. We've got coconut oil, and this one has actually the flavor and the scent of coconut. So, yeah, this smells like...
If it's a coconut, it should have.
Yeah, well, no, some of these coconut oils, they have no flavor whatsoever. It's all neutral. But this one smells like... you know, like in the 80s when you were sunbathing and you wore that coconut oil? Oh, wow. Very good.
Put it somewhere.
No, we're going to put it in the pan. But hang on, don't put it in the pan yet. What I was going to say is that we've got this coconut oil and it's flavored with coconut flavor. And I'm going to take, let's say, about a teaspoon like this much. And I'm going to put that in my pan. There we go. And then I'll take an extra half a spoon because it's so good. And apparently it's supposed to be really good for you. So there you go, lovely coconut oil in the pan. So So thank you so much for doing such a beautiful job. But they all look almost the same size.
But you know, if I can't have the porridge, maybe I should show people what I eat instead of your porridge.
Okay. So, 2 pairs, 1.5 teaspoon of coconut. I'm not listening to you. Now pears go in the frying pan. Just let that cook for a little while. Turn on the heat. And I'm gonna add, to make that salty caramel sauce, I am gonna add a little pinch of this Maldon salt, which we love. It's flaky, you know, not the fine one, but flaky salt. And I'm not gonna add too much. I'm just gonna do, you know, a tiny teaspoon. It goes in there. So, Arne.
Yeah.
While we stir fry the pears and do the porridge, let the porridge finish. We have to talk about Porridgegate.
Yeah.
So where are we?
I haven't had porridge since the quarantine.
Well, that's not true. You've had this one a couple of times. The pear porridge.
I had that one. I did it two times. So I had that one 2 times. I haven't had the cold one since the quarantine.
Okay.
And why? I'm not sure if I want it.
But look at it. It's so irresistible.
It looks good, but I don't know. I'm still on the porridge game.
Yeah. So what have we been eating?
I've been eating my sörl. I don't know what that is in English.
It's like a sour milk that you've mixed with flat bread,
yeah.
I think.
I have that.
Yeah.
I have a lot of that. And sometimes I do instant noodles.
Yeah.
And sometimes bread.
Yeah.
But normally I don't eat bread because that's something I save for when we stay in hotels. So then I have a lot of bread and cheese and stuff.
Yeah.
So since we're not going anywhere, we had this at home.
Yeah.
And also the croissant.
Yeah, we've been buying croissants and having that for breakfast. And I've been having quark with sliced apples and sliced pistachio nuts. So yeah, we went from all these vegan, amazing porridges to croissants. I don't know what happened, honestly. Well, COVID happened. Okay,
we
I
just
think...
We needed a treat, I guess. We needed a treat, or... Isn't that what it's called? Something sweet, something different.
Mm. So do you think we're going to start eating this porridge again, or is it gone forever?
No, that one I can have.
This one you like?
Yeah. And I'm not so sure about that one, because we had it... I really liked it before.
Okay. So while we finish cooking this one, why don't you give that a taste?
Okay. Let's see what happens. Oh my god.
Tell me what you think about it.
I haven't done this for a while. It is good. It's good.
It's good?
Okay.
So you like it now, again?
I can have it now.
Yeah? Well, eat up, eat up.
I don't know what happened because I lost my appetite on porridge and I've lost my curls.
Yeah, that was your COVID situation.
Maybe if I eat this, I get my curls back.
Maybe. Okay, so... Final steps
here. The raspberries
here.
Is it raspberries?
Yeah.
They're so good.
So I'm going to join you in a minute with a hot porridge. There's one more step to go. Pears are now stir-fried, nice and warm. Starting to get a little color. And the last thing I need to do is add the, you know, thing that will make this caramel-y. And again, it's some Canadian maple syrup. I had two pears, one and a half teaspoons of coconut oil, and I'm gonna add two, because it's for two servings, so I'm gonna add two tablespoons of maple syrup. So here we go. That's number one. And number two. The smells. You've got the coconut smell, you've got the maple syrup smell, the pears. And now once I start doing this and shaking the pan, you see it's turning into a nice caramel kind of sauce. Oops. And this is ready. So if I can have the plate, Arne, mm-hmm. I'm going to plate myself a delicious portion of this porridge. Oops. And I am going to add a couple of that in there. I want a little bit of the sauce as well. And you put the coffee machine on.
Yeah. Sorry.
There you go. I got my tea as well. And I am ready for my breakfast.
Okay.
Okay. Oh.
So, we have two different... Normally we have the same.
Yeah, but this is because we made the two different porridges for our viewers. Now, the question is, what does this taste like? It's hot.
Well, that's... I thought you liked it.
Oh, yeah, I do. I do, but it's quite hot. Yeah, the pears are nice and soft. Actually tastes like a good dessert, to be honest. But then you have all that porridge below, which is kind of good for you. So
maybe I'm back on porridge a little bit.
No.
Not every day, but.
When I cook my oatmeal, I like it to be runny. I like it to be watery. If it runs out of water, it gets too dry, and I don't like that. This is cooked perfectly for me. Good. And I think I could go back to what it was and do the porridge again. Now the question is, will you be willing to start doing porridge every morning again, or
not?
Are we...
every morning. Okay. Maybe once a week.
Once a week porridge,
so I can have my noodles, my sol,
mm-hmm.
and sometimes bread and the colourful
and a croissant.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Okay.
So maybe you're right. Once a week is enough. So once a week this porridge, and then once a week that one, right? Yeah. In the same week.
That's fine.
Okay, and but you will eat that.
Yeah, but not many times during the week.
Well, I expect you to finish that plate of porridge now. Well,
first, we have to say the rest,
Yeah, I'll do it while you eat. No,
you want me to eat on camera?
You eat and I will do the formalities. Eat up.
I'm not eating nicely.
Just eat. I just want to make sure you eat your porridge, because otherwise you won't grow up to be strong.
Okay.
So thank you so much for watching this crazy episode. Please keep in mind that it is extremely early in the morning, and I am super, super tired yet. Or still. You're more a morning person than me anyway.
I've been up for a while, so
yeah. So if I hope you liked the episode, give it a big thumbs up. And I seriously hope you didn't cough on my pears. But we have video evidence, so we'll have to have a look at that.
You have to check the video.
Make sure to turn on your notifications. That way, you'll never miss an episode. Give the episode a thumbs up if you liked it. And please subscribe to our channel. That is one of the best ways ever to support us and our YouTube channel. So, Arne, let's
now you should eat before
continue
it gets
eating.
Cold.
Well, this one's really hot, so I'm warm, so I need to cool it down a little bit. But anyway, we will be enjoying our breakfast for another 20 minutes, and we look forward to seeing you again.
Good. Bye.
Bye. What happened?
You're not talking with food in your mouth.
No, I didn't talk with food in my mouth. Oh.
No. I. Just let all the milk and stuff get out of the leftover because I didn't eat my porridge. I'm not so fond of it yet, again. So I'm gonna have some real food now. My breakfast. Because Carlos left the building. So I need some flatbread, and kulturmjölk, surmjölk, sour milk. This is good. This is what I call breakfast. So good. And have to eat quick before Carlos comes. Mmm. Delicious. So, Porridgegate is on again. I stick with myself. Thank you.